You know, out of all the pieces of legislation that we've passed this year in our Senate conference, one of the important ones they were able to take care of today was the extender on the brownfields. Now I know a couple senators spoke out saying, you know, that it really hasn't done much and it's cost the state a lot of money, and I don't know where they're getting their information from. That might be old information, but the information that I have is for every dollar that the state spends, they get over $3.50 back in taxes. For every dollar that's spent by the state, they get over $7 in private investments. So we're talking about a $7 billion private investment with 20,000 jobs, 40,000 construction jobs. If this program were to sunset in 2015, it would be a disaster, because you have organizations, you have contractors that are in the brownfields program right now that they won't be able to finish, so they'd be shut out. And then the ones that want to get in can't get in, because it's usually a 2.5 to 3 year period to clean a brownfield. So if it sunsets in 15, you're not going to be able to do it. I was disappointed because I thought agreements that were, you know, going on with the assembly, with the second floor, I thought we were close. The communications broke down. We started up again. I didn't think that we were that far apart in the assembly, but it seemed to be that, you know, the assembly had some legislation that was taking out certain portions of the state or certain benefits of certain portions of the state that would help out certain areas. It seemed like the second floor had an idea, but inadvertently they were taking out certain areas of the state. Our legislation actually includes the entire state, because we know that brownfields are different for remediation purposes all across the state. It's different from Western New York than it is downstate. So we thought our bill was comprehensive. We're going to continue to work off that legislation. The governor had great points in his. The assembly had great points, Chairman Sweeney. We just have to come together and get this done. There's no way the economic viability and vitality of this program does and what it does create is important. A lot of the brownfields in Buffalo right now that the governor, the Senate, the assembly, what we're spending on at Buffalo Billion, a lot of that money is actually building on sites that are brownfield sites that have been cleaned, that have been using this program, that have been dormant. But now companies are coming in from out of state, from actually other countries, coming in and building on these brownfields. So for somebody to come up to me and say it's not working is absolutely not correct. We actually have cranes in the air in Western New York. We have thousands and thousands of construction jobs happening. And at the end result, there's gonna be permanent jobs at the end, which only helps to bolster the tax rolls in the city of Buffalo and Erie County. That's what that program does. You have properties that are sitting there in blight and disrepair, that are vacant, that are not bringing any economic viability to an area whatsoever all across the state. This program works. We have got to do a reform that works for everybody. This extender is a fantastic extender, passed both houses. My understanding is the governor's going to sign it, and then we could finally come back and work together to get something done once and for all. But the brownfields program, all the memorandums of support that I saw are statewide. There's really no memorandums of opposition. So it's important we continue with it and keep it viable.